Hi everyone, welcome to Profit Ada. Today exactly I'm going to talk about task scheduling. Okay, so as you know, scheduling is a very much important thing. You know, if you want to run any kind of a program and you want to for a particular time you want to run. Okay, so suppose you know, I am storing this, you know, kite ticker, I mean data, whichever I am, you know, to run exactly, and I want to save them in CSV or database, and exactly I want to run them. So in this, what happens, 9:15 you know, begins for NSE, the data will get started, you know, from where you can exactly can fetch and can store. Okay, up to 3:30 you can exactly can fetch and store them. So for that purpose, you know, you have to start 9:15. So all you have to do is, like, first of all you have to say about your API key and access token wherever it is after generating it. Okay, so exactly I'm gonna show you, as you know, previous I have done a video regarding this WebSocket data. You know, exactly you can save it in CSV or database, is up to you. So here what I'm gonna talk about is, first of all I will just take these things and try to run with the help of task scheduler in Windows. Okay, so I'm gonna perform this operations. So exactly, you know, timing is very much required. So exactly I'm gonna run, I'm gonna show you how you can, you know, create your basic task to run these things. Okay, so this is this will be my file exactly, which I have been saved, and I want to run this ticker and want to save it in a CSV. okay, so all I have to do is I have to take a task scheduler. Okay, and I have to start with this one. So you can do, you can search this task scheduler, it is available on the Windows. All you have to do is, like, you have to go with the task scheduler library. See, the thing is, part in Python is also scheduler is there, you can make use of these things. Okay, this is what I like, you know, if you want to go with your Windows laptop, if you want to schedule anything, if you are logged in and you want to run something, this will be, you know, best for it. So all you have to do is, like, you have to follow this simple task which I'm gonna show you. You have to follow this. So you have to click on create basic task. Okay, if you click on this one, you know, window will appear. All you have to do is, like, you have to name that one. So exactly, you know, I'm running for my ticker, to save my ticker data in a CSV or database. So exactly I have to say, like, name ticker, and all I have to do is, like, I have to go for the next. We will, you know, we have to set this weekly because Monday to Friday. Okay, so for that we can set on weekly also, but we will do this later. So all you have to do is, like, go with next, and timing you can set here also. So suppose it is right now 7:29. Okay, so exactly what happens, it is right now whatever the timing is running now. So while doing this one, I will take as a 35. Okay, so while we're talking and setting, it will take around and it will run at that time. Okay, so an exact 0th second, or you can say as a fifth you know, second. So hour, minute and second, and the date will be okay, and recur every 1 day. Okay, so it is good. So we will just click on and you know, start the program. Okay, that's it. And we have to mention here programmer script. So exactly you have to mention where your file is. So my Python you know, .exe file, which I have to talk about here. So, you know, python.exe, so it is my executable files are here. So I am using exe to execute my files, and here optional whatever I just name my file. So it is, have you you have son that one. So it is like kite ticker.py. So all you have to do is, like, here you have to mention wherever a Python file is there. All you have to copy the link wherever a file is there, and come with the optional and save it here. That's it. Okay, and say next. So here it is done, your ticker is done. You have just check each and everything and just say finish. Okay, here ticker is done. Next, what happens, you have to go with your ticker, and some settings will be there which you have to do. So just check with the properties, and you know, conditions will be there. So you know, this is, you have to opt out, which is like you know, telling for if you are on AC or without AC. So exactly I just set with this one. Okay, so just check it out, and then actions is good. I wanna start right now, and 35 is good. Settings, settings is all good. Okay, and actions where exactly you can set each and everything. And one more thing is there, I want to get with the weekly, so all I have to do is mark Monday until Friday, till Friday. So you can go with this one. Okay, and just say okay, so it will get saved. Okay, so we will exactly wait for 7:35 exactly, 7:35 at 5th second it should run. Okay, so right now the time is 7:32, so we'll wait for 3 minutes more. Okay, so and another things I'm gonna talk about. So if you want to do, you can set n number of tasks here and can run at a time, not a problem. All you have to do is like you have to program perfectly so you are not getting any kind of a error. Otherwise if you are getting error, it definitely gonna cancel. So all you have to do is like set according to that one, go with the exception, try and exception, catch block, you can use catch block, so it won't be any kind of a problem over there. And set the time, and if you are in laptop and logged in, if you want to run any kind of a file, or you have written some program to automate your trades, so all you can do is like fill those details here and set according to the file name each and everything, and run those things, so everything will be taken care of. So all you have to remember is the thing point here, it is like there will be login, so there will be every morning you have to log in. So at a time, just what happens in midnight, all if your login will get cancelled. So one time just you have to log in, access the token and schedule the task and everything. If your laptop is on, everything will be taken care of with the help of your task scheduler in Windows. I want to tell that if you don't have a trading account, okay, all you can do is like you can go to www.profitadaweb.com. okay, so if you want to go with if you want to go with online upstocks trading account, you can go with this one. And if you want to go with Zerodha trading account, you can go with this one. Okay, if you want to open account with upstocks, just visit the website which I just told. Okay, and just fill the details, email address, password and your mobile number. Okay, and if you all, let me check whether I can run or not. I think I'm facing a little bit error here. So first of all, let's check with the properties for what exactly it is. So I'm talking about my kite ticker, and this Friday exactly I'm running. Actions, conditions and settings is good, and I have to check in this. Okay, so I think I missed my folder, so all you have to do is like my folder is Python 36. Okay, and I will schedule my task once again, so I will keep it this 38. Okay, and I will run this. Let's wait for it. So this time it will definitely gonna run. You can run from here also if you want to, but we will wait for some time. And let's check from task scheduling. Okay, so all you have to do is like proper follow steps. You just have to mention your folder, the file name, and where exactly your file belongs. Okay, and you can set whether you want daily this task, weekly, or these things. Conditions is with the opt out. If you choose that one, if you are not in power, AC power, your task will be taken care. Otherwise, it will definitely gonna. Okay, so as you can see, my task has been started and there is no error, and it has been started. Okay, so my kite ticker, obvious what happens if any error is there, is it has been taken care of, and it will give time for retry and all. So as you see that I am extracting this MCX data, okay, which I am saving in my CSV. You can exactly can see in the CSV instrument.csv, it is exactly getting saved. So you can opt these things. Okay, you can try on. Okay, so I must say you just go for it and try on. And the part is, if you want to, you know, run many tasks at a time, you can do. You just have to, you know, go with this process, create basic task. Just start with create basics, basic tasks. So it will be good. So it will, if you just create, start with create task, it will ask for the login. So it better just go with the basic task. And yes, that's it. You can try by on. And one more thing is there. So suppose, you know, previously in my videos, if you go through, just let me tell you about this one. You know, 320 is what you have to do is square off. Okay, so you know, function is there, invalidate access token in this Zerodha Kite Connect. So you can invalidate the access token, and this you know, whatever the task is, it won't carry. So until 320 you need to square off. So I think you don't need to square off this, all those things. All you have to square off is your trades. Okay, so I think previously I have done a videos regarding that one, like, you know, at a time how exactly you can you know, square off. See, book or exit order complete from buy or sell. Okay, so two videos are there, you can watch from this one. You can opt this things, you can exactly can say about positions, and can square off all those things. And in this, scheduler will definitely gonna help you. What it will note it down each and everything your timing, and it will pop up, and first of all it will clear all of your, it will book the profit or exit, and then second it will invalidate the access token, so further it won't run. So it will definitely gonna help you a lot in intraday for the trading purposes and for tracking and all. This is what the thing you can use it, this is what you can rely on. And other things we will definitely gonna talk furthermore on another video. For now I'll just wind it up. Thanks for watching. Please do like, share and subscribe. And so suppose if you want to support the ProfitData, a link will be there in this end of the video, which is left side of yours. And if you have any other doubt regarding this video, doubt or queries, you can comment below. If you have any other queries or requirements, you can contact me direct via WhatsApp. Thank you.